deal with the challenge of finding new customers and putting those 10 people on the in the seat of the car? What approaches do you have to finding those people?
Well, let's say that having such a powerful product, when we launch a new model, I would say, depends on the model actually, but I would say between 30 to 50% of clients are repeaters. So normally, who purchased the car in the past that will purchase it again and again and again. Sometimes keep it at them all, sometimes simply sell the old and buy the new. So the relative number of repeaters is very high. So this protects us against a big surprise. Then, of course, especially launching and opening our brand to new segment, it's already more than 10 years, we entered the GT segment, like it used to be 50, 60 years ago in Ferrari. Ferrari was since the beginning producing GT, but then became famous for sports car. But with the launch of California, that was the coming back to Ferrari in the GT market, of course, we enlarge a bit the potential clients. So there were a lot of new clients to Ferrari. How do we get it? But you know, there are several marketing ways to collect prospects. But at the end of the day, the key issue is to have people sitting on the car and have a test drive. This is the real selling point. Because no matter how beautiful is the car, no matter how the level of personalization, color, and so on and so forth, you can put in the car, the real difference is always the driving. The driving experience is what makes a Ferrari completely unique. And it's not, I also aesthetically love the cars, and someone more, someone less. But I can tell you, you can choose color with the competitors. They have they have hundreds of colors. Also, they have personalization. It's not too many competitors in our in our segment. But at the end of the day, we have 5, 6, 7 what we consider our competitors, and they are all. They are all good cars, of course. They're very good cars. But our car is unique in the driving experience. There was one of the previous CEO that I love it because he always say that, is that when you buy a German car, you buy most probably a perfect car. But the end of the day is like you buy a perfect refrigerator. It's perfect, fantastic, but it's cold. When you buy a Ferrari, maybe sometimes we are not perfect, as I said before. Maybe sometimes we have small problems, or we have, you know, some very little issues. But you are buying a passion. You are buying something that you sit on the car. Oh my God, you feel the difference on the engine, on the soundtrack, on many things. I mean, when we design and we build engine, I'll give you a small example, we are not only thinking about power, whatever, everything. I mean, 1 to 200, 1 to 100. That's the parameter that, of course, then is the selling point. But for us, it's absolutely important, the soundtrack. One of the engineering ones told me that the engine was perfect, but it didn't have the right sound. So, sorry, we don't want it. And they have to redesign the engine because it didn't have the right sound. So the sound of the car is an integral part of the experience when you drive. And when you sit on the car and overall you have the driving experience, including the soundtrack, you get in love with it. I think that we have one of the highest conversion rate in the industry. So you drive it, you want it. Yeah.